Hey everyone, Grant K for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, we're going to focus on updated grouping functionality in the Action Schematic. This will allow you to better organize your flow graphs when there are a lot of objects and you want to make the flow graph more manageable. We'll only be looking at the nodes in this video, so you can use your own media and flow graphs to follow along. Here I have an action schematic that consists of a series of node branches that I would like to simplify in order to make it easier to work with. So you can use the grouping functionality to hide the nodes you don't need to see all the time. In previous versions of Flame, creating a group was limited just to a branch of nodes, and if you needed to edit the group, you needed to ungroup the structure to retrieve the nodes. So working with a group was quite limiting. In Flame 2017 Extension 1, grouping is now based on a selection, and it's very flexible. To create a group, you create a selection or a multi-selection of nodes. It does not matter where they fall in the flow graph. Now you can make a group in two ways. Either call up the contextual menu and choose Group, or click the Group button to the right of the interface. The node selection is collapsed into a single group node. So you can already tell that grouping nodes can hide complexity you don't want to see all the time. It's also a great way to tidy the action schematic. Now, if you had grouped an entire branch, you'd just be left with a group node and nothing else. But since you can group by selection and not include entire branches, the remaining nodes in the action schematic will display dotted connections, indicating that they are connected to nodes in the node group. From this example, you can see that there were connections going into the group node, as well as connections coming out of the group node. So that's creating a group node. Now let's say you want to edit the contents of the node group. You can get into the group in a number of ways. You could select the group node and call up the contextual menu. Here you will find an edit group function. The edit group function is also mapped to the F8 keyboard shortcut. The F8 shortcut is actually the action object view because you are looking into the node group. And finally, for those who prefer a gestural approach, just double-click on the group node. In all cases, the viewport switches to the object view, and you're now looking into the group node. So the solid nodes represent the content of the group, and the semi-transparent nodes represent the other nodes in the main action schematic. This gives you an overall context of how these nodes fit into the context of the action schematic. Secondly, the solid connections show what is internally linked in the group, and the grayed out connections show what is externally linked into the group back out to the main action schematic. So just to give you a sense of how far you can push these views, switch to the 2-up view with Alt 2. In one viewport, you can press the tilde keyboard shortcut to load the action schematic, and in the other viewport, you can press the F8 keyboard shortcut to display the object view of the selected group node. You have the ability to see inside the group and the main action schematic at the same time. In a visual sense, you get to see the dynamic link between all the objects in and out of the group. The grouping behavior in action is now identical to the grouping behavior in batch. The general idea is that you actually have one schematic, but you are hiding a portion of it within a group node. And at any time, you can look at the group nodes in the context of the schematic. Now press Alt 1 to go back to a single viewport. Go back into the group node if you don't see the object view in your viewport. As part of the grouping enhancements, you can also add, edit and delete nodes in the group. In fact, you treat the group as if you were working in the main action schematic. So go to the action node bin and drag out an axis node into the group. This axis node is now considered as part of this group. You can even create new connections and join branches together within that group. So that's pretty handy. What is also extremely useful is the ability to work across the group and the main action schematic. For example, even though you can see the dot connections, which indicate links outside the group, these are fully editable. So you can break connections, as well as make new ones to the objects outside of the group. It actually does not matter if the connections are going in or out of the group. But I want to point out that when you do create external connections from within the group, you are explicitly creating connections between one node at a time. The reason why I'm stating the obvious is if you go back to the main action schematic with the tilde keyboard shortcut, you can also connect nodes into the group from this level. The only difference is when you create a connection to a group from the main action schematic, it links to all the nodes at the top or bottom of the branches. You can even think of this behavior as a macro script to speed up the workflow. For example, select the group. Go to the action node bin and drag out a shader node. The default behavior of the shader node is to auto-connect with the selection. So that saves an extra step. When you select the group node again and enter it with the F8 keyboard shortcut, you can see that the shader node has attached itself to all the geometry nodes in the group. Similarly, if you had connected an axis node to the group, all the nodes at the top of each branch in the group would attach to the external axis node. So just to reiterate these points, creating an external connection within the group is one node at a time. Or creating external connections from the action schematic will link all the node branches in the group as an automated process. Connecting an axis to the group will create connections to all axis nodes at the top of each branch. Using lighting, GMOSC, shader, and texture links will connect to all the geometric shapes in the group. And finally, using Substance, will automatically create material and shader connections to all geometric shapes in the group. You can always edit them afterwards to get what you want. This works with the majority of nodes in the Action Node bin, so it should not disrupt your usability as you move in and out of the group nodes. Finally, I'd like to finish this video with a few extra pointers. When you move an external node in the group nodes object view, it's also changing its physical position in the main action schematic. So if you switch back to the action schematic with tilde, you can see the node's new position. But if you move the group node in the action schematic and then switch to its object view with F8, you will notice that the contents of the group have not moved in relation to the group node. If you wanted the content of the group node to shift with its new position in the action schematic, you need to hold Shift and drag the group node. The next time you look into the group node, you will see the node's positions have changed. Lastly, if you want to ungroup your nodes, you can do it in two ways. You can either double-click on the node and choose Ungroup from the menu, or you can call up the contextual menu and choose Ungroup. So that takes care of the updated group nodes in the action schematic. But be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.